Hello and welcome to Farming Simulator 2015. It's been like 3 months since I did a video on this, and then we were only testing it. Now we're going to see if we can actually play a game. So we'll give it a try. We'll start a career. We will start it at normal in Bjornholm. Just basic stuff. So we are waiting for it to load. It will be a second or two. There we go. Would you like the tour? No, thank you. Yeah. We have the question mark here. Yeah. Welcome to the farm, blah, blah, blah. All good and well. And we got a combine. As I said before, it's nice now that we don't have the farm. We have a combine that's a little bit bigger. It can carry a little more grain to begin with. It makes it for a little easier to get your farm up and running. We have a field over here that's prepared but not really ready yet. And we have a tractor with a trailer standing over there. Let's see, you can connect a trailer. You're ready to do this. Here. You can do it. You are going to be seeding. And we will get some bigger equipment as soon as we can, because this seeder is way too small. It takes forever and the cultivator too. Those are very, very tiny and they don't really work for us. Work as well as they could. Yeah, I think we need to farm the market and not what we want to farm. There we go. They have actually made it that now the grain in there is used by the driver, and when it's spent he will keep working, but it will cost you a lot of money. Oh, it's spouting out stripes, yeah. Well, we'll just deal with that because we don't need it. We don't have any way of collecting it, and I'm not sure we would want to, because we're not at the point yet where we have cows, and without cows it's pretty pointless to collect the straws. The money you get from selling it is so little, so it's ridiculous. So going into selling this straw, I haven't had any luck with it, and I don't think it will be something that we'll go for in a big way. We have one more tractor. Can we buy a fertilizer? What's it priced? Oh. I do have this one, but I can pretty much do without it, so much rather have a fertilizer. Thank you. And when I'm done harvesting, I can go down and collect my fertilizer. Using equipment, because that's much more useful. I think there's one combine load in all of this, because this, as in 2013, is a field that have been sown, but they haven't sprayed it, so there's no no real money coming from that. Dirty old Dutch tractor going up and down. It's a very expensive tractor to have on your farm. Now, should we have a look around the farm? We haven't really done that. We've just dropped right in and began work. We never ever saw anything or did anything. Let's go up and have a look here first of all. Here's our house. Nice and big and everything. A wooden log cabin. Very much like Swedish style building. I think that's what they went for, and a steaming hut. So you can go and take a steam bath if you need to do that and get all the bad thing out. Here is the straw or the hay bale sales point. And we can walk in it, and there's hay and stuff. The hay doesn't pay enough for you to buy the equipment, I think. Well, when you get to having cows, maybe, but before that, no. Just don't. Too much work, too little money. Small storage. I don't know. But it's a small storage of some sort. Here's one of our machine sheds. And it's got an upstairs too. Whoopsie, the hay loft. It may not be used for hay, but it's there. Our plow is here, it's the small one. We may use it to connect the two fields out here. We may use it for that. I haven't really considered it yet, but maybe we should. Seeds, wood chips, that's a new addition. I haven't really played around with the wood chips enough to know if it's profitable. Maybe I should, I don't know. I haven't really considered it. Potatoes, sugar beets, just as it used to be. The industrial fertilizer. A small working shed or something. Conveyor belts for the beets and potatoes. The grain silos. The drop-off point. The new silo system. If you played Farming Simulator 2013 and you played the Idaho map, you'll know this system. It's the same thing. Drive under here, choose which grain type to be released, and then it's released into your trailer and off you go. Water, if you want to do the plant and everything. Telephone, if I want to call the helpline. I don't really, shall we? Great demands explained, and here you can get explanations for everything. So that's basically what the helpline does. It helps. More storage for your machinery. So, and this area will be used a lot to park your machines in, I think. At least I use it for that. Oh, we have a full combine. We may consider emptying that. Let's go. And you can see the wagon fills up according to where the spout is from the combine. It's not a uniform layer all over. Let's go down here. Let's do this. Now, in the beginning, we need money, so we're going to the freight yard. Because the freight yard has a magic stick that we can, or magic lever we can pull on. Magic stuff happens. And we kinda need a lot of money. We may be going back and forth here a few times to get all into the train station. Because that's what we need to do. We need to get it to the train station. One of the things I know can help a new farm is cutting down some trees and selling them. That can really help. Because it gives good money to cut down trees. Basically, you need a chainsaw and a red forestry wagon, and then you can go for it. Use the forestry wagon with the crane, that's the easiest thing. Don't go for a front lifter, that's... In the beginning, it's a waste. Selling our stuff. Because that's a lot of what you do as a farmer. You sell stuff, you buy stuff, you sell, then you harvest. And sometimes you plant something to harvest. Yeah, that's a minor thing. This little tractor is struggling, it's a Hurleyman, it's a 90 horsepower tractor. It's very, very low on power. I can't really do what I needed to do here. It's what we got right now, so we'll work with it, even if it's a little underpowered. Now, I usually save the potatoes and the beets for a rainy day, and I think I'll do that too here. Just say here, they will be saved for another time. You start with less powerful tractor than in 2013 farming simulator, but on the other hand you get a more powerful combine, and I think that's a good idea. They want a more powerful combine. In FS13 we got the Burr, the 130 horsepower tractor. Here we get the 90 horsepower tractor. On the other hand, we get four of them. In the FS13, I think we got two or three to start with. Depending on what map you played on. I think Westbridge Hill, you got three tractors, and if you played in Hagenstadt, you got two. Oh yeah, you got the small 75 horsepower, the red one. But I think I did what most people did with that one. They sold it as soon as they saw it. Because it just simply didn't have the horsepower. I think in this year, in FS15, they done a good job of balancing the tractors more. But you also have to keep an eye out, because there are tractors that are really expensive in here, where you, as you would in real life, where you pay for the name, not for the horsepower. And then you have to decide, hey, on my farm, do I need the horsepower or do I need the famous brand? What am I going for? Am I going for fame or for a real good workhorse? Do I get most for my buck or do I get fancy badge on the front? You know, you can still get the fancy tractors, but yeah, I don't know. And I noticed this time we didn't get a tractor with pre-ordering on Steam. Last time in FS2013 we got the Lamborghini, the R6, the big Lamborghini tractor. We got that with the pre-ordering, but we didn't get anything this time. That's okay. I don't think a lot of people actually use that Lamborghini much. It looked nice, but silo is soon to be empty. And once it's empty, we go down and pull the lever. Oh yeah, we need to empty the combine too. Things go together. I think most people now have seen this sort of shortcut to freight station. And you notice we are probably in some part of Sweden where there's a lot of hills. I would guess that's the idea. So many trees we could cut down for good money. And I think we will, at some point, cut them down, get some good money from all of this tree stuff. Time has now been slowed to normal. That's important when we're showing that it's not running too fast. And I've seen a lot of people using the I button to get into the submenu to increase the speed. Get to grips with your keyboard. Learn to use the 7 and 8 key. They increase and decrease the speed. Much easier to go into the submenu. Just simple number 7 or number 8, depending on whether you're increasing or decreasing the speed of the game. This trailer comes in a lot of colors. You don't have to have any green as you start looking. If you're a real secure man, you'll get it in hot pink. Then you need to be really secure of yourself if you're going to do that. I'm not getting it in hot pink, I like the green one. Maybe a red one, but not a hot pink. Front weight might be a good idea for this one. It's sliding a little. But the tractors are not sliding as much as they were when it first came out. They were sliding all over the place. And I think some of the updates to the game has fixed that issue. To a point where it's tolerable. It's not like... It's not horrible. They're not on the driveway. Anymore. That is okay. don't know about this, but we'll see if this game has a good 2 year, or maybe even a 3 year run. This has been a trend that we got 111, 113, 115. So, we'll see how long this lasts. It's nice, this one, that they included two maps. The Westbridge Hills map, which is very popular as I understand it, and this one that's getting up there in popularity too. So that's nice. FS13, we only got one map, and the same with FS11, I think we only got one map to begin with. And of course people modded like crazy in all the farming simulator series. I think you can find mods dating back to 09 version of the game. The modding community is very active, and sometimes they produce good maps and sometimes they don't. But I like the good ones, the ones that work. And who makes the best mods is very difficult to say, because it depends on what you want to do on your farm. Do you want a big, serious farm? Do you want a fun farm? Some use this game as a free world where they can just drive around in cars, you see. And then they just download whatever Lamborghini, Ferrari, whatever car that has been made, and then they drive around in that. Some specialize in low income stuff, like they want to do the hay bale things. I've seen a lot of people online offering hay bale services. And then they specialize in using the front lift and doing all that, so they're sort of showing off their skills. I've seen those that have taken it too far, they have gone and done their own version of a modified joypad and joysticks. That's perhaps a little excessive, but on the other hand, if you have a hobby, then why not? Well, what are we doing? We're trying to unload. Yep. Side, yeah. Yep, that's a fine parking space for it. Our little combine. As you can see, these things get dirty. They get dirty inside too. There are mud tracks in the wheelhouse. Oh yeah, and we got the speedometer to work now. So the dials are not just there, they're actually doing something. So let's go up and down. Up and down. And then I hear my little hurdy man. Yep. Okay, let's go down to the train. Put this stuff in and let's see if we pull the handle and get a little better. Or where we are. Chopping down the trees is the fast way of earning some money for your farm. let's face it, these tractors are way too small if we're going for some of the big fields. And I think that's what I want to go for. Then there's equipment. Just won't cut it. It's too tiny. Combine is okay, it's not the biggest, but it's okay size. Oops. Stop driving on the road when I'm... It may damage your car. I don't care so much for my own tractor. It's dented and bent and everything. And we got our first DLC for this game too. The trailer with the hook and different attacks that I got with it. I'm a little no, too small for DLC for me. And I'm not sure that I really need what it offers. It looks nice enough, but I don't think I really would ever use it, so I don't know why I would get it. But then on the other hand, a lot of people said that the Ursus Mark DLC for the FS-13 seemed a little strange, but it ended up, as far as I know, for a lot of people, that the Ursus tractor were quite a good compromise. They were cheap and it had a lot of power, according to the price. So, let's go in and drive with me. Oh, we can actually get into the wood cutting business. That might be something we'll do. We'll go back to the farm, park us up, buy ourselves the trailer needed and a chainsaw, and we'll call it an episode. I think that's what we'll do. But we got a lot of extra money just from pulling the lever. I usually park them right here, consider this my parking space. There we go. Purchase with a P. And forestry equipment. That one I don't see any real use for. No. Those two I can see an idea in, but it's when we get to the real money. This one is the good one to begin with. Yep. And chainsaws. John Seared.